What's happening, folks, and welcome to an episode of the Real Madrid Beta Series. My throat is still not great. I've got a fever for a start, that doesn't help. Thank you so much for raising the support on the channel, guys. I really appreciate every single person watching this content because I'm looking forward to FM20 content, both on Twitch, which is where I can reveal now the Bradford City is going to be. I might still put the streams on YouTube. I don't know yet. They'll be long videos, though, so I might do that if I can get it so the music's not in it. Today, guys, it's second versus third in the Madrid derby, so hopefully we can get a win. Don't forget down below, leave a like, a comment, subscribe to the channel, all that jazz, as usual, as I'm sure you guys are pretty good at doing. So we go, guys, look at the fixtures first, how we got on since you lost with us. So we beat Olympiacos 3-0 in the Champions League group stage, which has basically got our qualification done, essentially. Bale, Jovic and Milito with the goals. Dominant performance, not much from Olympiacos at all. Just continuing the good form really in that game. 3-0, pretty simple really. Espanyol 4-0. The stats down here don't show that, but it actually was a very good great performance. The scoreline doesn't reflect the stats. They were a threat occasionally, but it didn't feel like a 4-0 thrashing performance that we did. But again, Bale, Varane, Hazard and Rodriguez with the goals again just kept that form going. And yeah, it was a weird game, but hey, I'll take a 4-0 victory again. That seems pretty close. This game, I have no idea what happened. We couldn't pass the ball, we couldn't create, we couldn't defend, we couldn't do anything essentially. Lost 3-1. Just don't know what happened in midfield. Literally, we got the ball in midfield and gave it away. And Zenit had just every single time they went forward that they were going to score a goal. Which means we aren't qualified yet, but we're close. Just disappointing, really, that we couldn't nail it. Not so much the fact we lost the game. It was how we lost the game. We didn't play. If we played well and just got unlucky with a couple of counter attacks, and fair enough. But we couldn't pass, couldn't defend, and our attacking play was, well, obviously, as a result of that, non-existent. So the table wise, we're a point behind Barcelona, who got two of the top two goal scorers in the league. We just need to just match their results really, and try and just hopefully they drop points at some point. Who are they playing this weekend, actually, in this group? They're playing Eibar. Eibar a bit higher than I thought, but I can't see dropping points there, can you guys? The Champions League group stage looks like this. We need a point in the final day against Lille to get through the group, which would be great if we could do that. Because of that, I'm considering doing the Lille game next and then the Barcelona semi-final, because the semi-final could go longer than I anticipate, because it could go extra time. It's unlikely given my luck, but I'm thinking we do Lille next to just in case there's some kind of freak result we don't get out of the group. And then just in case there's something, then we do Barcelona and then Barcelona again. That's what I'm thinking doing. The beta is just to have fun, guys, and just, you know, we're not going too long term into this save. So I'm thinking we do that as a personal choice. So yeah, I think we'll do that actually. Because in the finals, I forget if it's home, it's going to be on its own, because obviously it could be extra time. And the Lille game is kind of important now, because we could theoretically not qualify. So I thought I'd like to show that kind of game. If we beat Zenit, I wouldn't do it, but, you know, we'll go for it, guys. Let me know, guys, down below if they're okay with that kind of thing. It's just for future reference on the full series, if it's okay. Iron this kind of thing out now, and then we can hit the series running on the full series when we start it on FM20 full release, rather do that now then ask that question now and go forward. So we've got some transfer news. We've got a player leaving the club. Modric is leaving. He's going to go, I think, to Man United, but he could go to China. It depends who he prefers. We've signed Bruno Fernandes. I went for Pogba, but the fee they were asking for was too much, and I thought, you know what, he's a good player. He can play cam as well, so we've got a double option there. And he's a really good player. And the corner kicks and set pieces are handy as well. So, you know, it's kind of either or really. And I thought, I'll go with the cheaper option, just to guarantee I get a placement in, rather than sell Modric and not be able to get Pogba in, and then, you know, end up getting that Bruno Fernandes anyway. So, let's go, guys. Look at the team selection here now. Right. Well, I'm gonna bring Bale in because I rested players for the game at midweek, and I'm kind of regret doing that now. And yeah, we'll go with that. I do apologize about my voice, guys. Take a sip of water here. Well, not water, juice. it's a league of content, to be honest. That's bugging my voice eventually. So they're playing 4-4-2, which is not what I would ever play in this, in with them. I probably play at least two attacking wingers. Give us a cheers today. Here we go then. Hopefully, a win. And hopefully, a few goals to score as well. I'm loving FM20. You've made a little tweet I put out to not try and get a response from Miles, just to put a tweet out there just to say thank you for the great launch of the game. But this is miles better than FIFA. It is. As I had a penalty here. Wow. Nearly a goal there. Just the way their launch of the game, which is essentially the beta they've launched it, is a beta. And they've said that is an issue with the game. EA launched a game as a so-called finished version, and it ends up being the arse backwards in terms of how they've launched it. So props to Miles, if I'm not watching this, but props to you. Oh, God, so let's see this again. Okay. Wow. I think nobody's challenged for that. I want to see this again. So, Bork was in from Lamar. Yep, just run straight in and no marks him up. Poor. Very poor. But again, you could argue confidence is low from that game. We lost to Zenit. So, you know, but again, that's a bit poor from Hazard that he sees the guy that he waits too long. Oh, no. Don't be like that, Carvajal. Okay. That hopefully is not a. Hopefully it's just a one off. Because that, again, pass the ball, boys. Don't know what's happened last couple of games, but the passing midfield is going to be non-existent. Bale, pass the ball. See, again, pass the ball. There we go. Gedson. Swings it into Jovicic. And again, ball's going straight for our midfield and no one's picked up well to Isco. Hazard, Isco. Good ball to Bale. Bale in the penalty area. Jovicic. Well, Jovic, no. Again, just players taking touches rather than first-time shots. That's something I've noticed a bit recently in the last couple of games. They get chances to pass the ball, take a touch, rather than do the first-time pass. Oh, he's off. Stupid. 22 minutes to get sent off. It just feels... Well, we're buggered now, boys. It just feels like... It just feels like everything's falling apart right now. Nothing's working. We can't pass the ball in midfield. We can't create opportunities. And we can't defend. Nothing works right now. So let's miss a free kick. Oh, damn it. Just so frustrating when you can see they're going to do a foul and you can't do it about it. Cruz kills it in. Hazard. Cruz. Again, that should be fisting straight away. I don't. It's offside anyway, but you know what I mean. Get creative. Again, I don't expect... I think we're going to lose this game now. I don't think I can really do formation-wise. Lamar, the figure, kills it in. Well done, Courtois. But it's just so poor from a set piece that we can see the goal from, you know? He's got a free run and no one's fault. You know what? Let's mark the guy running towards our net to get the ball. And long ball to Hazard is not going to work. Well done. Good tackle. Gedson. Hazard. I'll take a draw on this game based on the fact that I'm 10 minutes. Bill's phone go. Bale. Yeah, one of the ones he's fixing. That's a thing, actually, in beta I've noticed a lot. That is a thing. He wouldn't chip the ball from that position. That's the goal. This is going to be a goal. Oh, wow. The chips for one goal like that were annoying last year. Hopefully that's not the case this year. He should just place that. Chippy 8, Sal. Keeping near post again. Bloody Courtois is near post. Wasn't really counter-attacking. Was it really? That's poor. I mean, I want to see this again. I mean, Courtois... Maybe he's unsighted, but it's just poor. We're down to 10 men. We can't pass the ball to save our life. I need to go tiki-taka. I need to get the ball back. Tiki-taka to try and pass the ball. We're lumping it long and we're not winning the headers. They're not winning that either. See, not winning it. Oh, well, you glanced it on. Okay. But we're just not passing the ball properly. And again, in behind. Costa's in. Varane. Oh, for God's sake, guys. Can we just defend? I know we're down to 10 men, but come on. It's just it's the same happened against... Look at that. That's poor from Varane. So poor. Just, guys, just defend. Jeez. So poor. 3-0 down. They just can't defend at the minute. That's 6 goals in 2 games. Where has this come from? Today, it's the 10 men. But just everyone get behind the ball deeper. Don't play offside either. The offside trap is, I don't like offside trap on Foot Manager. Sorry, I don't like playing it. I think this is the area just gets way too in behind way too easily. In my experience, it does. But come on, guys. It's just the midfield's been crap. That's a really good pass. Well done. Oh, just this is the one thing that frustrates you about Foot Manager. Oh wow, that was, guys, come on. Just show some desire. You know what? I'm taking Hazard off. We lost this game. We're taking him off. Rest him for the game that we actually win. But it's not so much the fact we're losing these games right now. It's just the fact it's come out of nowhere, these performances. I don't understand where they come from. Literally out of nowhere, we just can't defend, pass the ball, attack. And that's the frustrating part. Is I can't figure out what's happened to the team in recent days. Marcelo. Hazard, Bale. Oh, nothing goes our way today, does it? The red card really hasn't helped, obviously. But I just feel like, I wonder if you guys feel the same way that... Oh, for God's sake. This is 4, isn't it? Just the fact they got the ball there. This is why I don't like Tiki-Taka, because, again... They just take it gives them license to keep the ball and just, well, take 20 touches on the ball. Ball in the box. So Jovic, oh, that there, that's where I want that mistake from Lito. I want him to say, I'm under pressure, get rid of it. But because I've got Tiki-Taka on, it feels like he's got to play a short one when realistically he's going to lose it if he don't play a forward pass quicker, which is poor from him, really. Cruz, can we get a goal back? Nope. How are we doing possession-wise? We've got more possession of the ball, believe it or not. Again, you got to go for that. That's the ball we could have easily won. So, again, can't get over the ball. We're closing down and getting sent off in here. Costa, GPA, Sal. The ball's just fall. You see the difference in the ball possession. It falls. Look at all the yellow cards, man. What is this all about? What is all this yellow card business about? Every single defender is getting yellow carded. Show some passion. At least score a goal. But I don't think we're going to. And I'm going to look at Cruz, Gedson, and just say, what the hell are we doing in midfield? You cannot pass a ball 5 yards. At least score a goal. Come on, Marcelo. Cruz, 4 passes. Quickly, 4 passes. Bale. Great ball. Great touch. Great tackle, to be fair, from the player. Cruz with space. Jovic, Bale, the shoot. Too many touches is the problem today. Too many touches in the final third. They get the you know what? Go route one. Why not? Try and get one back later on. And get Benzema on. And you know what? Get Gareth Bale off, actually. Actually, no, I can't. Benzema can come on for Jovic. Just bad day at the office, really. But it's just the fact that he's come out of nowhere. He's... Oh, wow. It's just come out of nowhere, these two results. And that's the frustrating part. If I could see something happening... Okay, don't need to see that. If I could see something happening, you know, in the interim, be like, okay, I can see problems here. I could have maybe said, okay, it's been coming, that. But it's not been coming at all. We dominate every single game. We've been playing well. Defensively been good and taking our chances. All of a sudden, we can't do any of it. The red card was an issue, though. Look at that. Booked in the 2nd minute, then booked in the in and set up in the 23rd. So quick between the two. Disappointing. But the run has been great, generally speaking. But just these two results out of nowhere have really frustrated me. So, next episode, we've got Lille in the group stage Champions League. That could be a tough one. Based on the form we've got Getafe and Eibar next, who are near the bottom. So, hopefully we can get a bit of form back. But it's just frustrating how it goes 3-0, 4-0, 3-0, 2-0, 3-0, 3-1, 5-0, 5-1. Then all of a sudden down here, just out of nowhere, we lose one game and then they just fall apart. I disregard this game down here, though, because I think it's just down the red card, did it? And against a good team, you know, that can happen. But regardless of how, luckily, I don't have to get annoyed. Bale's out for how long? 4 to 5 days. Doing not anyway at the moment. That's two games anyway. Cavarel, he gets discipline, so that's good. Don't have to do that anymore. He's fine. That's a good thing. I would go nuts on him usually, but don't do it this time. So, thanks for watching, folks. I will see you in this episode. Hopefully, we can get a bit more form back against Eibar and Getafe. But, hey, we'll have to wait and see. But next episode is Lille in the Champions League decider. Till next time. Bye-bye.